What's going on, everyone? Jeremy here from The Quartering End. Things appear to be getting worse for the disastrous Santa Inc. The holiday special with, in their words, not mine, a touch of feminism. That's right. Some feminist cheer is what apparently this movie has. Now, what the movie does have is 167,000 dislikes compared to 4,000 likes. That's probably what, a 40-to-1 dislike to like ratio. Not great. The show currently sits at zero. Like, why aren't critics reviewing this? Why are no critics reviewing this? Isn't that like a suspicious thing? This is a great opportunity for critics to talk about, you know, pwning the incels, and they haven't reviewed it. Oh, but things get far worse. And I'll get into all that after a quick word from this video sponsor. Huge shout out to this video sponsor, Established Titles. Now, this may be the most interesting sponsorship I've had yet. Established Titles is a project based on a historic Scottish custom where landowners are referred to as lords and ladies. The Established Title Pack gives you at least 1 square foot of dedicated land on a private estate in Scotland and an official certificate with a crest. It looks absolutely sick. Lord Jeremy from The Quartering, my official proclamation. Also remember that they have a charity partner, Trees for the Future, and One Tree Planted. They plant a tree for every single order, which is absolutely awesome. So you can get this sweet gift for someone or yourself. You can get a certificate proving your title as well as a unique plot number with which you can see the exact location of your land. Established Titles might be one of the best last minute gifts ever. You could get even a couple pack for you and your partner where you get adjoining plots of land. Getting this certificate also helps you officially change your name to Lord or Lady and get it on a credit card or some other, whatever else you want apparently. For those with Scottish heritage, it's also a great way to connect with family. Established Titles is having a great limited time sale, so go to establishedtitles.com/thequartering to save 10% off today. And remember to use the discount code thequartering, or just click the link below. That's establishedtitles.com/thequartering. Now, yesterday it appeared that they had locked the individual reviews. It seems that they've let a few through now. There's 1,009, and it has a score of 4%. 4%. Four. Now, it is legendarily bad. What's interesting is, and I've always said, it's only 1,000 reviews. Where are all the people that watched this and liked it? If 100 people watched this show and liked it and gave it even an 8, you would have a score probably in the 20s or 30s. But there are no positive reviews. They are nowhere to be found. And last night, the show was reviewed by Shamika Michelle over, I think she's with, I'm not exactly, well, let's see who Shamika's with. Let's give her a follow. She's an author. She works on Fearless, on The Blaze. Let's see, let's just take a little look at what she had to say about HBO Santa Inc.
This is why that I don't care what color the feminist is, she can kiss my ass.
Whoa.
in real life.
Let's go over what...
I mean, she didn't like it.
And Shamika, I'm just wondering, did this thing strike you the same way that it struck me?
Jason, first of all, I thought it was funny that they got rid of the black man who was going to be the successor to Santa Claus in the first episode.
Uh-oh.
And then the next three episodes, the feminists spent the entire time trying to be equal to the white man. So I was thinking, did they do this on purpose?
Yes, they always do it on purpose.
Black man, which is why I turn my nose up to black feminists who joins in this foolishness. Every male in this show was either a misogynist or somebody that was just an asshole, or he was a beta male.
Exactly. Isn't that true? Good. Hey, worth a follow, Shamika. Tell her, tell your boy Quartering sent you. Good take. Yeah. Guess what, boys and girls? I did watch this show, and it was terrible. It's just like all the modern shows where all the men are idiots and, you know, the women are constantly the unsung heroes. Like, look, some men are idiots. That's a fact. But some women are too. And it seems like, you know, this was a trope with, like, you know, even Homer Simpson, Peter Griffin, all your most all these most popular television shows, the men are buffoons. And it's kind of like gone to another level where all men are buffoons in these shows.
There were no positive men in this show at all. And so, you know, people say you get this out of just a cartoon. I got this all out of a cartoon.
And I think it's funny, by the way, the whole cartoon nonsense. It's a way to gaslight and deflect, right? It's the same reason that these weirdos were talking about. By the way, she doesn't look like a very good white supremacist, by the way. You know, like when you criticize He-Man or She-Ra, right? People come around like, it's just a cartoon. Yeah, but it's also a cartoon that is targeted towards the adult demographic. Like, Santa Inc. is targeted towards me. So was She-Ra. And so was He-Man. It was targeted towards adults who remember, you know, in She-Ra and He-Man's case, you know, adults who remembered the original shows. Otherwise, why would you bother calling them that? Santa Inc., obviously, you know, it's R-rated. So it's targeted towards my group of people, my age group. And, you know, people like to come in and be like, oh, it's just a cartoon. You can't pleasure yourself to a cartoon? This is just, again, how weirdos who know exactly what these cartoons and television shows are up to, how they try to shut you up. Now, I'm not saying every television show with a message is like some nefarious, evil, mustache-twirling person behind the scenes. But what I am saying is many TV shows have a message, and it's baked in. Sometimes it's overt and on the surface, and other times it's underneath. Sometimes it's both. To deny that Santa Inc. wants to disparage men, and particularly white men, is to not watch the show at all. Of course, that is the tool that they use, because the female in the show can't get anything done on her own merits. She, you know, you have to constantly, basically every man who's in a position of power didn't earn it. And this woman just can't get a break. She's just so clearly superior in every possible way. But the darn patriarchy, you know, is keeping her down.
It made me feel like I was Damon Wayans in the show in Living Color when he was the prison guard. Like, the proclamation of the ejaculation when he was the prisoner, because this is what I got out of the show. And I just couldn't believe that what my eyes were seeing. I just couldn't.
Now, again, I'm not going to like feign outrage and say this is a children's show and it's not intended for that audience. It's intended for me. You know, and you see even more articles, you know, Seth Rogen blames Supremacy for new movie. It's a TV show. Santa Inc.'s dreadful 3% score on Rotten Tomatoes. Tone deaf Twitter rant gets blasted in the replies. Well, yeah. People saying, have you considered the audience rating isn't based on Supremacy and that maybe it's just actually not good? You know, to deny that there were like comments made that were not okay. I mean, there were. I saw them myself. You know, I don't know if they were jokes or if they were mean-spirited, but that sucks. Why? Well, obviously that's not okay, period. But also, it's allowed Seth to use that as a complete shield for the nonsense. Now, Seth has obviously stayed away from talking about it. He hasn't tweeted about the show in 5 days. He knows it's trash. Like, and yeah, you have what? If this person really is black, that's an epic own. What's up with the reindeer, Seth? because the reindeer are all like black stereotypes. You can't just attack people's religious holiday and expect no backlash. Neither Christmas nor Santa started in America. He's from East Mediterranean. He has nothing to do with your racial divisions. Also, the show feels like it was written by an 11-year-old edgelord. I mean, well, that's who it's for, right? I would imagine that's who it's for. And between him and Sarah Silverman, it seems like they've completely abandoned the show. No talking about it, no nothing, you know, in days. They've completely abandoned it. Kind of like how Kevin Smith completely abandoned his second season of He-Man after that got utterly trashed. These people don't care about the product that they put out. They care about the message, as critical as Drinker would put it. And it's garbage, and you shouldn't let them forget it. Shouldn't forget that their whole thing was trashing, a Christian holiday, Christmas holiday, and then pretending, getting faux offended when people got mad about it. You can make good programming, and you can make good comedy when you work hard. This was just lazy crap, and they got offended that people called it out. Hope you enjoyed this video. We'll talk to you again real soon.